WeTechCareOfYou, and today I'm just going to show you a very quick video on how you can get the ID of a record from a patch function in PowerApps, where you've just submitted to a SharePoint list. So let me just show you what we've got set up here. So as you can see, I've just got a SharePoint list here called PatchID, and we've just got, I've put a test record in for now, but we've just got the ID field and the title field. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this patch function. And when it puts in the new record into the SharePoint list, I'm then going to populate this label with the ID from that last patch. So from the latest patch, what we've just done, the newly created records, we're going to get that ID. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show you how I've set this up. So basically, we've got our patch. So we've got a button on select. And on the patch, I was looking for a lot of documentation on this, and there's quite a few videos online which are actually really long, but I thought I'd do a quick one just to quickly show this. But say, for example, you've got your patch function here. What you want to do is basically just put that into a variable. So you're setting a variable here, LastPatchID, and then you're doing the patch, and then that variable will contain everything that's patched into that to that SharePoint list. So sorry, I noticed that I just need to make a change here. ID. So as I explained, we do the patch, all of that record goes into this variable, LastPatchID, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show that ID from that variable. So I've got the variable .id. Now what I'll do is I'll put all of this code into the description of the YouTube video, but I'm just going to show you how this works now. So if I just run the app, I'll click the button to run the patch, and as you can see, that straight away set that label to be 2. So if I come back to our SharePoint list and just refresh the page, there you can see it's added the new record, the test patch from the app, and the ID was 2. So if I just run that again, you'll see that goes up to 3. And as we do the patch, it just keeps incrementing by the 1 because it's incrementing the ID. I hope this video helps someone. Please like and subscribe to the channel, and take care.